The seven-year tribulation. Are we in the seven-year tribulation? Hello, y'all. I'm Diana Breanne. I don't give advice, suggestions, recommendations, or information. I just share with you my perspective on different topics, as is with this one. Okay. I hope you like, share, subscribe to all five channels. Links are pinned to the top of the comment section below. If you connect with me with all five, I will likely connect with you with all five. And remember to connect with my big channel, which has over 4,000 videos on it. Okay. Well, so what am I talking about today? Well, Grandma's Porch channel, Grandma's Porch with Diana Breanne Fairchild, is a little bit more about hot topics, topics that are trending and that people are talking about. And I'm keeping them separate from my main channel, okay? My main channel is a little bit about everything, about my life, about my wisdom, about sharing wisdom. It's about everyday life. It's about my stories. It's about, you know, wonderful stuff. And so is this channel, but this channel is gearing more towards current events and current topics. So one of the questions I get asked a lot, are we in the seven-year tribulation? And if we are, what part of the seven-year tribulation are we in? Well, you know, I believe, and these are only my opinions, okay? And so the seven-year tribulation, so what do I think about it? Well, I'm not a Bible scholar. Okay, I am not a Bible scholar, but I grew up with the Bible. And Grandma would sit out on her porch and she would, you know, read us the Bible. And at night when we would call her on her old rotary phone, and we had a rotary phone back in the early 60s, she would talk about the Bible to me. And when we didn't have a phone, I'd take my little dime and I'd go down to the payphone down the road at the truck stop. I was probably 5 or 6 years old, and I would call Grandma. And that was when you could have unlimited time on that payphone for 10 cents. And I'd call Grandma and she'd preach me the Bible. So I'm not a Bible expert or a Bible scholar. I'm just a grandma. I learned from Grandma, okay? And I read my Bible. So having said that, I'll give you my viewpoints. Now, your viewpoints may be different. I know a lot of people have different viewpoints than me. And don't let your viewpoints divide you, okay? Let them bring you together. You can have a difference of opinion without being divided, okay? Well, first of all, you know, there's a big division amongst, I think, Christians about the rapture. What is the rapture? Well, the rapture is where everyone is taken up into heaven suddenly, without notice. And so there's two forms of rapture. Some people think it comes at the very end of the tribulation, and other people think that it comes prior to the tribulation or somewhere in the beginning of the tribulation, so they don't have to go through it. Well, I'm going to give you my opinion, so I know I'm going to get a lot of thumbs down from the people that believe in the rapture coming after or before the tribulation. I personally don't think it comes before the tribulation. I don't think that there is enough that I have read in the Bible that says that. Unless you're reading between the lines somewhere, I don't see where it directly says that this happens beforehand. Now, I know that there's a lot of books wrote on it, pre-tribulation and the rapture, and how the rapture, the people are taken up so they don't have to live through the seven-year tribulation. I would love that. And I hope you are right. I hope I'm wrong and you are right. Okay. But I don't want to mislead people. I think sometimes we're hopeful because we want to avoid the negativity. We want to avoid the bad stuff. So we'll make up something in our minds. And I'm not saying that that is the way it is, that people are making this up at all. I'm not saying that. But I think sometimes they're hopeful that there's going to be a rapture prior to the seven-year tribulation. There could be, like I said, I could be the one that's wrong. So I'm likely to hear, you're wrong, okay? But me personally, I would be more prepared for the seven-year tribulation to come first and to have to live and endure through that than to actually make it be taken up to heaven, so to speak, prior to. And so the rapture is all about, you know, being taken up. And so does it happen before or does it happen after? I don't know. Okay, like I said, I'm not a Bible scholar, but my opinion, remember, opinions are fluid and they can change. My opinion is that that it happens after. So now we're going to go into the question, are we in the tribulation? Is the tribulation coming soon? What's going on? Where are we in the tribulation? You know, to be honest with you, I don't know. I don't know. There's a lot of signs, and you know, that the Bible talks about that have taken place or in the process of taking place. And I think that there are some that have not taken place yet. I think, you know, growing up, we were living in the last days back then. That was 60 years ago. We were living in the last days, and it was coming soon, you know, and it didn't happen. So do I think we are living in the last days? Well, I've talked about this in another video. I don't know. I don't know that answer. I don't know. I don't worry about those things. Okay, people get caught up into these type of things of worrying about it. Do I believe in preparing? Absolutely. I believe in preparing for a thunderstorm even when it's sunny outside. I believe in having a rain, an umbrella in my car for that just in case. You know, I'm a just in case person. So I would be prepared for the 7-year tribulation if there was going to be, you know, Grandma always had a food cellar. Grandma had a food cellar. Now people call it prepping. She had a food cellar. Okay? Grandma was way ahead of her time. And so I believe in preparing with food. I believe in preparing with things. I believe in staying alert. But I don't believe in living in fear. I don't believe in living in fear, because if God is in control, and I believe He is in control, then He has a plan for His people to make it through. To make it through. Okay, so all this worry, oh, is the rapture going to come or not come, or when's it going to come? I'm not worried about it. If it comes beforehand, that's wonderful. If it doesn't come until after, that's fine. If we're in the tribulation, we'll get through it. We'll get through it. And if we're not in the tribulation, well, then we'll just keep on building our lives as we always have. You know, is the world a chaotic mess? Yeah, I think it is. I think it's a very chaotic mess like I've never seen. But then again, the world has always had chaos, okay? It's just that now it's magnified because we can see it. We can see clear across the world in just a second through our internet. 300 years ago, it took a lifetime sometimes for news to travel. And even at that, sometimes it didn't get there. Now we're seeing what's going on in all parts of the world. So that can kind of magnify the chaos. Okay, is there chaos? Yes, but there's also always been chaos. So, you know, a lot of Christians are saying, yes, this is the end times. Yes, the rapture's coming beforehand. You know, I don't know. I don't know, but I don't worry about it. My faith is in God. My faith is in God. And I know His hand is upon me and my life and my family. So I don't worry about it. You know, if we have to go through a 7-year tribulation, we'll get through it. Okay, and I'm not saying that we're going through it. I'm saying whenever it happens, whether it's now or 1,000 years from now, okay, don't worry about it, but be prepared and stay alert, okay? From my house to yours, may God bless you, and I hope to talk to you soon again. I hope you like, share, subscribe to all 5 of my channels. Links are pinned to the top of the comment section below. Talk to you soon. Bye-bye.